made it to day three of the challenge. Congratulations. You identified your core values. You've thought about the audience and type of community that you want to create. The third part is the fun day, my favorite day. We're going to work through two things, creating a mood or vision board for your brand. So we've done the work, the base groundwork that you need to figure out what your brand is. Now we get to work on the fun stuff, which is like color schemes and feelings and all the fun stuff that will inspire you to really create that brand and put it out there on social media. Like, this is the year. I know you can do it. I'm excited for today's activity. Okay. So the first thing you do when you create a mood board, this is, okay, I love this. And if you aren't doing this already, you're gonna find yourself, I guarantee, kind of doing this probably just as part of like subconscious habit as you get on social media. I like to call it strategic scrolling. So this is where I'll go to like the Discover page, or I will go to like certain people's pages who inspire me. And if you're on Instagram, I just love visuals. I'm gonna use this as an example, but you can do this on any social media feed, any way you want. You can pin it to like a Pinterest board. I like Instagram. Doing this on Instagram is really fun because they have the little tag tool on the side where you can click it and you can create sort of like your own Pinterest boards, but you can create collections of posts that you like. And so I love using this for inspiration. So that, you might do this always now, but I think for today, definitely do this. Spend some time going through and picking out the images or the post or the people who inspire you. Put them in one place, whether it's a bookmarked folder somewhere, whether you're pinning it to a Pinterest board, or again, I like using Instagram, and I'll like tag, just create boards of that. Collections, they're called on Instagram. So take some time to do that. So we're looking at the stuff that makes us feel inspired. Okay, so once you've done that, the next thing you're gonna do, and I should say, you can do this electronically or the good old fashioned way, which is cut and paste. This would be like your old school vision boards that maybe you did in like fifth grade. But I still do these every year. I actually have one. I wanna show you guys. This is the one I had from last year. It got ripped by my 2.5-year-old, just so, I guess, emblematic of last year. I have a little picture of things that inspire me, pictures that inspire me, images. But again, if you did this electronically or digitally, that's totally fine too. But what you're gonna wanna do is you need to put all of those things, as you look at them together as a whole, as a collection, I want you to write down the words, look at the colors, so things like bright, happy, like cool. Look at the tone, so try to do it on a visual level. So what are the themes that you're seeing? Are they brightly colored? Are they pink? Are they dramatic? Is it, look at the way the pictures are lit. What are they depicting? So try to note any themes that you find. That's on a visual level. And then the second part of that is think about words that inspire, like, why do you like these pictures? Is it because they're motivational? Is it because they're pretty? Is it because there's a purpose, or you really just like that they're doing this particular thing with their brand? So try and, again, there's that two-tier level of figuring out what it is that inspires you and what are the basically the common themes among your collection of images that you looked at. And so from there, you're gonna start pulling them into either a vision board, if you wanna do this the old fashioned way, or a mood board. You can use like Canva, again, you can use Pinterest, you can use good old fashioned Word on your computer, anywhere where you can pull multiple images together on a grid. I want you to create that. And you can use words, you can use colors, you can use those images that particularly you are inspired by. So that's the step number one in the activity. And that's really the fun part. I want you to print this out. I want you to have this somewhere where you can open it quickly on your computer. If it's a vision board, I want you to put it somewhere where you're gonna see it every single day. And I want this to remind you about, to remind you of the brand that you wanted to create and the brand that you want to create, the feeling that you want to have. And again, all this should be aligned with your core values and target audience. But I wanted to want that to remind you about how you want your brand to look and feel as you do the second part of this activity, which is come up with a schedule for yourself. So I know this can be hard, but we all know that algorithms on social media are notorious. They're going to favor people who are posting consistently. So I would say pick 2 to 3 times a week is all you need for most social media platforms. And the other thing I want to say as you think through it, we're at the final step of the process here in our mini challenge, and that is to kind of figure out how can you be consistent? What can you commit to building your personal brand? Because you do have to put yourself out there. You've got your mood board to inspire you now. Again, your brand is grounded in these very quick things that we have done in the past 3 days. But now you need to think about two things. You know, one, where is your audience? Like, where do you want to build your community? And I would say pick one or two. I know this sounds crazy. There's so many ways to do this. You can be on YouTube. You can be on TikTok. You can be on Facebook, Twitter, Pinterest. Like, there's so many. It can be overwhelming. Pick one or two where you can be consistent. And again, pick 2 to 3 times. Know that you're going to have to post at least 2 to 3 times on each platform to start building that community that you want to build. And so I would say pick a schedule for you. You know your schedule. If you can post on the same days of the week, that's great. I gave myself a schedule this year is I'm just gonna post 2 to 3 times a week. I wrote it in my planner. Some days I had to really kind of pull from within, you know, other weeks I would be out and something would occur to me that I would want to share with my community and I would post it. And so that's just how it works for me. I like to keep some of it planned and some of it spontaneous. And so that would be my advice to you too, but at least have that planned part to be 2 to 3 times a week. And then I know there are a ton of different social media platforms that you can use for scheduling, free and paid. Personally, I like Later. Later.com, we use that with our clients. They've got a pretty cool free version. The paid version isn't terribly expensive, but I also really like Creator Studio, which is Facebook owns that. So if you go to publishing tools on Facebook, you can use Creator Studio and it allows you to post to Instagram and Facebook at the same time and to kind of schedule things out ahead of time. And so those are the two that I like best. I'm excited to be in the live today to see what tools you all use. I know I've heard of Hootsuite and other things like that, but you know, sometimes, you know, I'll just post anyway, just when I know they have to post on Monday and Friday and I'll just make sure that I do that. So there are many ways to schedule, many things to do, but I want you to figure that out and I want you to share that and hold yourself accountable to that. Do something that is reasonable for you and then build on it if you feel like you can build on it. The other thing, the last thing, is to check in with yourself at the end of every month. Make a schedule, not only the post, but also to check in with yourself to kind of just very briefly and quickly see how your brand is doing. Notice what posts are getting the most engagement, what aren't. Try to follow those themes and try to always be serving your community better. And that, my friends, is how you are going to grow your personal brand, especially on social media.